Greetings for the day, dear students. This is my second lecture on bioenergetics and ATP cycle, and today I will discuss glucose storage. Storage of glucose as glycogen. The liver secretes glucose into the bloodstream as an essential mechanism to keep blood glucose levels constant. Liver, muscles, and other tissues also store glucose as glycogen, a high molecular weight branched polymer of glucose. Glycogen synthesis begins with glucose 1-phosphate, which can be synthesized from glucose 6-phosphate by the action of phosphoglucomutase and isomerase. Glucose 1-phosphate is also the product of glycogen breakdown by phosphorylase. Here we can see in this slide the glycogen formation. The K equivalent of the phosphorylase reaction lies in the direction of breakdown. In general, a biochemical pathway can't be used efficiently in both the synthetic and the catabolic direction. This limitation implies that there must be another step in glycogen synthesis that involves the input of extra energy to the reaction. The extra energy is supplied by the formation of the intermediate UDP glucose. This is the same compound found in galactose metabolism. It is formed along the inorganic pyrophosphate from glucose 1-phosphate and UTP. The inorganic pyrophosphate is then hydrolyzed to 2-phosphate ions, and this step pulls the equilibrium to the reaction in the direction of UDP glucose synthesis, which we can see in the next slide. Glycogen synthase transfers the glucose of UDP glucose to the non-reducing end, the one with a free carbon 4 of glucose of a pre-existing glycogen molecule. Another enzyme starts the glycogen molecule, making an A1-4 linkage and releasing UDP, which we can see in the next slide. This reaction is exergonic, though not as much as synthesis of UDP glucose is. So here we can see the reaction in this slide. Summing up, the synthesis of glycogen from glucose 1-phosphate requires the consumption of a single high-energy phosphate bond and releases the pyrophosphate that is converted to phosphates and UDP. Overall, the reaction is glucose 1-phosphate plus UTP plus glycogen gives rise to glycogen UDP plus 2-phosphate. Glycogen phosphorylase breaks down glycogen by forming glucose 1-phosphate in the following reaction, that is glycogen plus phosphate gives rise to glucose 1-phosphate plus glycogen. This reaction does not require any energy donor. We can notice that glycogen breakdown preserves the phosphate of glucose 1-phosphate, and that was used for the synthesis without the need of a separate phosphorylation step. The sum of the preceding two reactions is simply UTP gives rise to UDP plus phosphate. Since 38 ATPs are made from the oxidative metabolism of a single glucose molecule, this minimal energy investment is well worth the advantages of banking the glucose as glycogen. Glycogen synthase and phosphorylase are reciprocally controlled by hormone-induced protein phosphorylation. One of the most basic physiological reaction in animals is the reaction to danger. The symptoms are probably familiar to anyone who has had to give a public speech: rapid heartbeat, dry mouth, quivering muscles. They are caused by the hormone epinephrine, that is adrenaline, which acts to promote the rapid release of glucose from glycogen, thereby providing a rapid supply of energy for flight or fight. synthesis of cyclic AMP, which is an activator of enzyme, a protein kinase, which we can see in the figure. Protein kinase transfer phosphate from ATP to hydroxyl group on the side chain of the serine, threonine or tyrosine. Protein kinase C is a serine specific kinase. Protein kinase C is a tetramer composed of two regulatory, that is R subunits, and two catalytic C subunits. When it has CAMP bound to it, the R subunit dissociates from the C subunit. The C subunit are now catalytically active, which we can see here in this slide. Protein kinase C phosphorylates glycogen synthase directly, as well as another protein kinase synthase, phosphorylase kinase. Phosphorylation has different effects on two enzymes. Phosphorylation of glycogen synthase either by protein kinase C or by synthase or phosphorylase kinase converts it from the more active I form, independent of glucose 6 phosphate, to D form, dependent on the glucose 6 phosphate. Glycogen synthesis is reduced, although if glucose 6 phosphate is present in high amounts, the enzyme can still make glycogen. Phosphorylation of glycogen phosphorylase by synthase phosphorylase kinase has the opposite effect. The non-phosphorylated form of enzyme phosphorylase B is less active than the phosphorylated phosphorylase A. We can think of a for active to help remember the direction of regulation. Phosphorylase is then converts to glycogen to glucose 1 phosphate. The end result of this protein phosphorylation cascades is in increased energy supply for activity. Protein phosphorylation cascades like the one discussed here are a general mechanism of cellular regulation. Protein kinases are involved in the control of metabolism, gene expression and cell growth, among other processes. So this was all about storage of glucose. Thank you. Have a nice day.